Today is our second out of 10 series of The Value of Vet Medicine. Today we're going to discuss about the versatility of a vet. What is a vet really? What does a vet do? Are they really special? Or is it a fairly standard easy job? Unlike human doctors and general practice, vet clinics offer services relating to many facets of animal medicine, not just general practice. Do you know that we are one of the very few professions that can prescribe and dispense not only by the same individual, but also in the same location? Not even a GP can dispense medication. Yes, they can prescribe, but they can dispense it. That on its own is two professions rolled into one already, the doctor and the pharmacist. So not only are we your pet's general physicians, we are also their surgeon doing operations, ophthalmologists looking into eyes, otologists looking into ears, anesthetists, radiologists taking and interpreting x-rays, dermatologists looking at skin, neurologists treating the nervous system, psychiatrists addressing behavior, and oncologists treating tumor, and so on and so forth. In addition, we also address your concerns as well, give positive energy in terms of crisis and stress. All of that training, service, and value presented by a single individual. Vet nurses or back of house team are incredibly versatile in their training as well. Being able to monitor anesthetic, applying bandages, assisting in blood sampling like a phlebotomist, in charge of cleaning and hygiene, and dealing with customer service as well. One aspect which is unique in veterinary medicine is that we perform euthanasia. The physical, mental, and emotional aspects of this one deed can be extremely daunting indeed, resulting in stress, psychological, and emotional trauma. Not only are we expected to professionally perform the deed, we are usually also expected to provide a source of positive energy to the grieving owner. Consequently, our healthcare team must be adequately trained in all aspects of these areas. The investment we make in ongoing training for our team is significant. It is perhaps not surprising that the dropout rate or the attrition rate for the profession is significant at 38%. This is a report taken last year, which means that more than a third of vets in the vet profession, including nurses, they would stop being vets, leave the profession if they could afford it, if they could find a chance to. And just imagine, this is the profession where if I tell somebody that I'm a vet, I hear a lot of people going, "Ooh, I've always wanted to be a vet." Do we really? If it's really that attractive, why are so many people dropping out? Comment below if you know a vet that has dropped out already, and also in your mind, comment below, what do you think a vet does? Is it just someone who takes care of an animal? How do they take care of it?